Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden gained more ground on President Donald Trump in the battleground states of Georgia and Pennsylvania on Friday, edging closer to the White House, hours after Trump falsely claimed the election was being stolen from him. Biden would become the next president by winning Pennsylvania or by winning two out of the trio of Georgia, Nevada, and Arizona. Automaker Mahindra & Mahindra on Thursday announced various benefits, including an additional cash discount of up to ₹11,500, lower interest rates and easy EMIs for government employees on its vehicle purchases. Under the Sarkar 2.0 program, all government employees are eligible for additional cash discounts, zero processing and foreclosure fee and lower interest rates starting from 7.25%, the company said in a release. The festive season sale benefits also include the highest tenure of up to 8 years with multiple finance partners and monthly EMIs starting as low as ₹799 per lakh for personal utility vehicles. The US elections this year have left the voters in a bind since the winner of the presidential poll is not yet decided and counting is still underway. Supporters of Biden and Trump have taken to social media and are sharing jokes and memes to cope up with the anxiety. One of the viral memes shows the Republican incumbent saying that if Joe Biden wins these presidential polls, then he would leave the US, to which Biden retorted by saying, "Bye then." Delhi's air quality continues to deteriorate further, pushing the air quality to the severe category. According to the Central Pollution Control Board, the air quality index is above 400 in most parts of the city, with Anand Vihar at 422, RK Puram at 407, Bhavana at 430 and ITO at 448. The CPCB said that the concentration of major air pollutants PM2.5 and PM10 are high in the national capital. Experts believe that the dense layer of haze is a result of unfavorable meteorological conditions like calm winds, low temperatures, and stubble burning in neighboring states of Punjab and Haryana. Despite the uptick in economic activities after the unlocking stages, the hospitality sector is still reeling under the impact of COVID-19 pandemic. The sector did get permission to operate from June 8, but the state-specific restrictions and general fear among travelers hampered the ability of the sector to rebound. According to Gurbaksh Singh Kohli, Vice President of Industry Association, Federation of Hotel and Restaurant Associations of India, the nationwide hotel occupancies are just 10-15% despite nearly all the hotels being functional. At a time when the aviation sector faces huge revenue loss amid muted demand and travel restrictions imposed in the wake of the coronavirus pandemic, low-cost airline IndiGo is reportedly in talks with Pratt & Whitney and CFM International Inc. for its next batch of jet engine orders. The airline is in preliminary discussions with the rival manufacturers for jet engine order that would power about 150 new Airbus SE-A320 neo jets. As per the report, there is no timeline on when the deal will be finalized.